Hello friends, welcome back. Our today's topic is direction. As we know, direction is one of the very important topic for all kind of competitive exams. Let it be bank, SSC, railways, UPSC, CSAT and placement trainings. In all the exams, you can expect minimum 2 to 3 questions. So let's start with question number 1 and we'll try to solve it here. So before solving any question of direction, first we have to draw the direction diagram. So this will be N, E, S, W. Now Shiva is starting from his house, goes 5 km in the east. So where is east direction? So east direction will be in this direction. So Shiva is going to 5 km in east direction, right? Okay. Then he turns to his left and goes 4 km. Now how to decide right and left? So if it is clockwise direction, if the movement is in clockwise direction, then it will be right. And if the pen movement is in anti-clockwise direction, then it will be left. So put your pen point here and he turns to his left. So put your pen point here and this will become our clockwise direction. So clockwise means right. So definitely you have to go this side. You have to go to left, right? So Shiva is going 4 km to his left. Finally, he turns to his left and goes 5 km. Now again, put your pen point here. Clockwise means right. So this side will be your right. And this side will be your left. So again he is going 5 km towards his left. Now how far is he from his home and in which direction? So Shiva basically started from here, right? This is his house. So Shiva started from here and now Shiva is here. So in which direction, now how far is he from his home and in which direction? So from his home or house if you'll see, then Shiva will be in which direction? Shiva will be in north direction, right? See, this is north direction. So from his house, if you'll see, Shiva will be in north direction. Now, what will be the distance? So from his house, if you see, this distance will be 4 km because this is parallel distance. So this distance will be 4 km and from his house, Shiva will be 4 km and in north direction. See here, one more question may be asked to you. What is the Shiva final direction? What is Shiva final direction? So if they will ask the final direction, then the final direction will be this direction, right? Shiva is facing this direction. So this is west, right? So this is west. So Shiva final direction will be west, but with respect to his house, Shiva is in north direction and 4 km, right? So our answer will be 4 km north direction. Let's move to question number 2. Question number 2 is, Suresh starting from his house, goes 4 km in the east, then he turns to his right and goes 3 km. What minimum distance will be covered by him to come back to his house? So before solving any question of direction, first draw the diagram. So this is my direction diagram. Now Suresh starting from his house, goes 4 km in the east. So east is this side. So Shiva is going towards east direction. 4 km, right? This is east. Then he turns to his right and goes 3 km. So if Shiva will take a turn towards right, then which direction he will go? This direction or this direction? So that how we will come to know. If clockwise means right, and if it is anti-clockwise means left. And this we have discussed in basic video of direction, right? Okay. So put your pen point here. If clockwise means right and anti-clockwise means left. Clockwise means in which the watch minute hand and second hand move. So this will be our clockwise and this will be right direction. And Suresh is taking right turn and goes 3 km. So right turn, Shiva is going 3 km. So now Shiva is here and Shiva has started from his house, which is here. Now what minimum distance will be covered by him to come back to his house? Now, if Shiva wants to come back to his house, then minimum distance they are asking. See, if Shiva is again going back, then 3 plus 4 will be 7 km, right? But they are asking the minimum distance. So, minimum distance will be always this distance. Minimum distance will be always this distance. So, basically, you have to calculate this distance, right? Because this will be the minimum distance. If you go like this, then it will become 7 km. So, Suresh has to go from here to his house. Now how to calculate this value of x, that we'll understand. See, for calculating the minimum distance, we'll be using Pythagoras theorem. So what is Pythagoras theorem? See, when we have a right angle triangle, which is making 90 degree angle, and this is your base, and this is your perpendicular, and if this is height, then, sorry, this will be hypotenuse. If this is base, this is perpendicular, and this is hypotenuse, then hypotenuse will be equal to P square plus B square, right? And this is called Pythagoras theorem. So hypotenuse will be a square root of perpendicular square plus base square. So this is also a right angle triangle. If you see, this is 90 degree. So my hypotenuse x will be equal to P square. That is nothing but 4 square plus 3 square. So this will be 20, 16 plus 9, which will be equal to 25. A square root of 25 will be equal to 5. That means Suresh has to travel 5 kilometer to reach back to the house, and that is the minimum distance, 5 kilometer. So 5 kilometer will be the answer for question number 2. I hope you understood the concept and the solution. Thanks a lot for watching the video.